Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm a troop leader in Brooklyn, New York. Today, you're going to be getting a taste of the Senior Digital Leadership Badge by imagining what would happen if a leader from the past had access to the internet as you do today. So you'll just need a couple of easy things. You'll need a piece of paper, something to write with, and a way to do a little bit of research on the historical figure that you choose. So as I mentioned, I live in Brooklyn, New York. This is one of my communities. It's the one connected to where I physically live and work, and I'm also a troop leader, which makes me part of the Girl Scout community. And I also really love escape rooms, and I'm involved in a few different environmental causes. And happily, I've been able to find other people who care about these things using a variety of different digital media. So websites, social media, online forums, that just help us keep connected and sharing news and information. So these are the digital communities that are part of my personal digital footprint. So the internet was really created in its current form in 1983. So before then, communities with specialized interests, like my interest in escape rooms, they had a much more difficult time finding one another. So communication was slower, and although speeches and newspapers and books and things were a really great way to reach wide audiences, it was nothing compared to the power of, say, a viral video today. So when we're thinking about historical figures and what their digital footprint might mean, I'm going to use Amelia Earhart as an example. So Amelia Earhart, aviation pioneer. She was born in 1897. She founded a women's pilots organization called the 99s that's still in existence today. She was a career counselor for women at Purdue University, and she was very active in the National Women's Party as an advocate for women's rights. So what would Amelia Earhart have been able to do, and how many more people would she have been able to reach if she had had access to the internet? So I have created a web, which I'm going to show you in a minute, that starts to think about who her followers would be, what sites she would be a part of, who she would follow, how she's going to respond to people who might not agree with everything she has to say. And you're going to do the same thing. So start by creating a list of a couple of influencers from the past that you admire. You want to think about what message they were trying to get across, because that'll be the first thing you start with. So you're going to choose one of those people. So let me show you how to create the web. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to draw a map that looks like this. So you want a big circle in the center with your historical person's name right here in the middle circle. Oval. And then you want to have five rectangles. So two at the top, three at the bottom is how it worked for me, but really it depends on your piece of paper and how you want to lay it out. I just grabbed a cookie box to make my rectangles and then just drew my circle in the center. And then I wrote Amelia Earhart in the center there. Along with her name in the center there, you need to also write down what you think her goal was, or what you think your historical figure's goal was, in what were they trying to get the word out about? What was their cause? In this case, I think she wanted to empower women to fly and have adventures. So I'm going to write that here just so I remember as I'm working. All right, and now in each of these other boxes, you're gonna focus on researching a few different things. I want you to think about this box here is gonna be my digital community. And by my, I mean me as Amelia Earhart. So my digital community over here, I want you to think about what I share, what Amelia Earhart shares within that digital community. So what I share. And down here, you're going to write down who you follow as Amelia Earhart. Who does Amelia Earhart follow within her digital community? Who follows her in this one over here? And in this one here, write down how she deals with detractors. Meaning, if people disagree, as people do online, how do you think your historical figure would have responded to those naysayers, those negative comments? So let's write that down. So this is who I follow, and this is who follows me, with detractors. But that's okay. So as you work on your web, think about and ask yourself questions like, where would this person have found supporters and allies? Who's the next person in the line that this person would have wanted to be knowledgeable about this subject because they could get laws passed, or they had a larger megaphone, digital or actual, of their own. And then when you're done, stop and look at that community. And is that community something that you feel like you would have liked to have been a part of? And then bring it back to yourself. What is your own digital footprint? What do you do within your own digital community? And what does your digital footprint say about you? And are there things that you could do differently or amplify in order to further the causes that you believe in using your own digital leadership skills? So there is lots more information in the description below about digital communities, digital footprints, and how you can use digital communities and cultivate and curate your digital community to really help you further the causes that you believe most in. So once you're all done with all of this, you will have completed step 3 of the Senior Digital Leadership Badge. Hope you've had a good time. If you're looking for more activities like this, or even challenges or service projects or events, go to girlscouts.org and look around. There is lots of great information and fun things to do. So hope you've had a good time. Thanks a lot.